Well, good evening, people. First of all, this is not a show. I just wanted to come in and say Happy New Year. I'm not big on all of that customary, traditional stuff that everybody says. I try to be outside the box. But what I did want to do is come on and begin, being that this is the first day of the year, and I just wrote the book, No Friday Foolishness, and it's a self-help reflection book, I thought it would be the ideal thing to do is come on and kind of work through this book by using the social media platform for me to post a quick live segment. And I'm only going to be on here for a few minutes. Shout out to Tamika Dean for joining me, Tirha Solomon, Carmela, Muhammad. So I wanted to go through with the book and just kind of work by it, week by week, each week, giving one of the statements in my book. So if you don't know anything about the book, it's called No Friday Foolishness. It's a self-help book comprised of 80 Friday weekly morning thoughts, where I post my thoughts and they're related to relationships, family, child drama, health, education, work, friendships, loyalty, mistrust, and the dating game. The same chapters in my book, In Cocktail Conversations, which I believe these themes cover the gamut of stuff that people go through. Shout out to Nene for joining me and Ronell for joining me. I will break down my interpretations of my thoughts, and the readers in this book will be given a chance to self-reflect on how they feel about these thoughts and how it relates to their life. So again, I'm only going to be in here just reading statement one. So each week I will kind of do one. And then I'm still going to have my regular weekly long show. So the first one is in the book, if you look hard enough, you may find some dirt. But when you look into that person's eyes, what do you see? So my interpretation of that statement was, no one has a squeaky clean past, but certainly if you dig deep enough, I am sure you will find something. But when you look into that person's eyes, what are you going to do with that information? Have you ever been in a position that you had to search for information regarding your partner? So this statement pretty much dealt with when you're in a relationship, you may be feeling some insecurities and you start prying, start looking for stuff, going through phones, checking, washing clothes, checking pockets, looking at receipts, bank statements and things like that. But the question is, when you find that information, what do you do with that information? How do you handle it? So think about that. Reflect on it. If you haven't got your copy of No Friday Foolishness, I'm on low now. I'm on a low inventory now because I just had a book signing in Niagara Falls this past weekend, which went pretty well. So I'll be stocking up with more books soon. So again, reflect on that. You can reflect on here. Like I said, I'm only going to be on here, probably about to get off in a couple minutes. But take the time to reflect on this thread. I'm going to share it. You can share it to your page. And I just wanted to see how this will work. So statement number one, if you look hard enough, you may find some dirt. But when you look into that person's eyes, what do you see? And we all know when you start looking, again, you're going to find something. But also, sometimes if you're caught up in your day-to-day life doing things, you may not even think about that. You may feel something right. You may feel something isn't right, but you may think to yourself, like, listen, I'm busy. I be caught up doing what I'm doing, so I'm not going to start looking and kind of lurking for information. Because, again, what are you going to do with that information once you get it? A lot of times people have a lot of information, but they don't do anything with it. So, again, if you look, you shall find. Maybe you shouldn't look. That's the question. Shout out to Dietrich for joining me. TK, Janet, Julio Hendricks. And again, like I said, I only came in here because I'm going to start doing this and try to work through my book, No Friday Foolishness, self-help reflection book. Get it? Because we always talk about around this time, making goals and self-reflecting, and we say it verbally, but we never write down anything, something to go back to. Because like with anything, when you get older, you may come up with a goal, but if it's something you don't see or no plans were put in place, more than likely, you may even forget about that goal by February. So it's time to start reflecting. It's time to start making changes. It's a whole nother decade, 2020. If you don't make goals, if you don't write stuff down, it doesn't have to be on paper. It can be in your phone or somewhere to make notes. Your 2020 will look like 2019, 2018, 1995. You get the picture. So with that said, I'm out. Feel free to make commentary on this video. Please share it. No Friday Foolishness, statement number one, relationships dealing with, if you look hard enough, you may find some dirt. But when you look into that person's eyes, what do you see? Meaning, if you, once you find it and you confront them, what are you going to do? Are you going to cave in? Are you going to make changes? What are you going to do? Shout out to Maria Wilson for joining me, and shout out to my man, Ron Robinson, for joining me. So good people, I wish everybody a prosperous new year. You know, it's a chance to reflect, make goals, do what you need to do to be better. And I really think this book is a key book to helping you with that guide. Ron said, keep up the good work. No doubt, brother. No doubt. You know I'm going to keep pushing. And this is my last statement. I got a friend who bought this book, and they said they were at work. They had some downtime. So they hit me up and said, hey, David, you're a genius. And I'm not trying to toot my own horn. I'm just trying to say verbatim what the person said. She said, I really like this book. I really do. She said, I'm reading through it, and you're touching on everything that I've been thinking for the past year and a half. She said, so right now I'm actually writing in the book and journaling and thinking about some of the things that I went through. She says, so, you know, keep doing what you're doing, and this is definitely good. All of these issues in the book is something that I've kind of experienced or know people that experience. So just wanted to throw that out there. Also, if you have my book, feel free to go on Amazon and make a review. That helps. You may have not got through the book yet, but you kind of know the theme of what's going on, that you can also drop a statement in my in the Amazon reviews. Reviews look good. So with that said, I know I got to go back to work tomorrow after almost a couple weeks off. Middle school kids, they're going to be amped up, excited, talking about what they got for Christmas, what they did over the holidays, sleepovers, what's going on in their social media stuff, and they'll be ready to create drama. So as the counselor, I guess I need to be prepared for those students to be sent down to my office to kind of process their almost two-week break. So I don't think it was a wise idea to come back to school starting on a Thursday, but you know they have to have that sit time, those calendar days that they have to be physically sitting in the classroom. So that's where we're at. So I'll be called to task to do that tomorrow. So I just wanted to drop a line. Hey, Anitra, how you doing? So I'm out. Like I said, if you can reflect on the statement number one, feel free, and then share it to your page. This is not a 30-minute video, so you don't have to worry. It's quick, to the point, and just share. All right, good people. Again, talk to you soon. Stay tuned for up-and-coming shows in the Counselor's Corner. And Anitra, Happy New Year to you as well. And I'm out, and I'll talk to you soon. Peace.